Christmas. Yes, I know December 25 has passed, but Christmas season is not over yet. For many, the Christmas celebration was different. Less people gathered in our houses, in our homes, but probably there was still a lot of food to eat. Christmas of 2020 is memorable not only because of the pandemic, but because of the reason for the season, which is the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Now, the last Sunday message of 2020 will be done by our founding pastor, Reverend Delphine Cardinal, who will give a meditation on Luke 2, 10 to 11. Let us pray. We thank you, God, for our Savior, Jesus. We thank you, God, that we can celebrate Jesus every day of our lives. We thank you for our worship time together. Holy Spirit, help us to hear your message today. We pray for the Silverthorne family, for their comfort from the passing of mine and Helen's mother yesterday morning at the age of 98 years old. May you give them a supernatural peace that comes from you. We lift it to you at the Marilyn Illumin and Tinai Valerete. God, you are compassionate and merciful, and therefore we appeal to you for a miraculous deliverance from their ailing bodies from head to toe. Lord, we ask in Jesus' name, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, for our celebrants this week, Noel, Joshua, Tanai, and Lydia. Regardless of their present situations, we give you thanks for another year for them. We pray that they may seek you first in their lives. For any struggles, we pray that it may bring them closer to you. We pray for healing of their hearts and minds and body. We pray for choices that they make, that it may bring you glory and honor. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Luke 2:10-11. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which shall be to all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, which is Christ the Lord. God, through the angels, brought the good news of great joy to all people, that the Savior of the world is born today. What a powerful and wonderful message that has been brought to us. God has given this precious gift to us, and in response, may we also give our tithes and offerings to the one who has given us the Savior of the world. Thank you.
message that I would like to share this morning is entitled, We Need Not Be Afraid. The question, what are we being fearful at this time? I think this is a really bad question because we are experiencing today the plague of coronavirus. It is a timely encouragement, the statement of the angels to the shepherd, fear not or do not be afraid. They did not understand, the shepherd did not understand what is happening, that even in this, in the night time of being a faithful workers of guarding and watching the ship in the midst of the night, the glory of God appeared to them and they were fearful. They were scared because they do not understand what is happening. And yet there is the word, the timely word that the angels had given to the shepherd. Do not be afraid. Or do not be frightened. Why? Because God has given us your word. And his word that today, this is the message. This is the good news. Do not be afraid. Why? Because God has sent to us a deliverer, the Savior, Jesus Christ the Lord. In the city of David, a Savior was born to bring joy to all people. So in the midst of our fearful situation, God gives us this assurance that there will be joy, there will be peace, because He has come to be our Savior. He will deliver us. He will take away our fears. Number one, why are we fearful? Because we do not know what is going to happen. We are fearful because we can be separated at any time, but yet God intervenes. And the greatest work of the Savior is that when Jesus Christ took our sins on the cross, the heart of the gospel message of the Christian faith is that Jesus Christ came to deliver us from our sins. By the shed blood on the cross, He poured His blood for us so that our sins will be covered and remembered no more. He grants us forgiveness. He took away the wrath of God upon us because He has promised that by shed blood on the cross, our sins are forgiven, covered, and remembered no more. Praise God, because this is the greatest joy that we receive at Christmas time, that Jesus Christ is the greatest deliverer from separation, from sin, because sin separates us from God. And yet when we accept Christ, Jesus Christ, God receives us and become the children of the kingdom of God. And He gives us the power of His Holy Spirit and the timeless word of His truth and the scripture give us assurance that His promise will never be changed. I will be with you through all the ages to come. So number one, that we should not be afraid because Christ is already here to be our deliverer. Number two, we should not be afraid because the promise of Jesus Christ that He will always be God, that will abide with us to all times and eternity. We will not leave you forsaken. We'll not live alone. We cannot face this situation today without God, but we can face it because of Jesus Christ. The comfort of the Holy Spirit gives us the assurance that when we face the difficult times of plague and pestilence, the scripture says that we will not be afraid because Jesus Christ is the God that abides with us. He stays with us. He controls every situation. He has power to rule over situation. Even when the couple, Joseph and Mary, went to Bethlehem, it was by the decree of Emperor Augustus. But it is also God who made it possible for Joseph and Mary to register, because it is God who controls human history. He overrules the decree. He used the decree to provide an opportunity for Joseph and Mary to register in Bethlehem. Hallelujah! We know that God is the ruler of all history. We thank God, and we there will no fearfulness in our hearts because Jesus Christ is God, always with us in all our situations. We thank God, even as we look forward to the year 2021, we look with a bright hope in our heart because Christ is born as our deliverer, our savior, our healer, our friend. Hallelujah. Amen.
The chorus in Angels We Have Heard on High is Gloria in Excelsis Deo, Gloria in Excelsis Deo, which is in Latin, which means glory to God in the highest. May we give God the highest glory for all that He is, as well as all that He has given us, like the peace that we can have even in the midst of a storm. And may the love of the Creator, the joy of the Spirit, and the peace of the Christ child be with you now and forevermore. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.